and welcome back. For this week's video, I tried myself on a 3-marker challenge. Therefore, I put all my neatly organized copics in a box. And yes, indeed, it hurts to see them so not organized. And blindly picked 3-marker. You can't see it here, but I had a sleeping mask over my eyes to make sure that I don't see anything. In the end, I had BG09 blue green, G43 pistachio, and B16 cyanine blue to work with. I prepared the line art already in advance to make it even more random. Therefore, I picked a mermaid as motif because that would go well with most color combinations I could get. First, I started with the skin. Since I neither had a really light or dark color, I used the green so it would stand up more against the blue that I would have to use for the water. At the beginning, I just wanted to put some shades down with this color, but the contrast against the white paper was too big. So I went over everything again with the green. I used a light stroke to let the color look lighter, even so it gave me some visible color strokes. Then I used B16 for some shadows and blended everything out with the green. This looks way more vibrant and more three-dimensional than just using the green for the shadows, so I'm really happy that I decided to color the whole skin green. Then I colored the fish parts of her in B16 and did the first layer of shading also with this color. Then I wanted to use the BG09 for some more intense shadows, but noticed that it sadly was nearly empty. So I have to use its belly in this drawing. Originally I planned to use that color for the stony part, but well, seems like that wouldn't work. For the hair, I didn't want to make it just blue, but green wouldn't work either because of the skin, so I decided to layer both colors over each other to create a slightly turquoise color. This way I also get a bit more color variety in the picture. For some darker strands, I then used the BG09 again, but it's not that much visible. But since I was using my white gel pen in the end anyway, that wouldn't be much of a problem, I guess. So then I had to color the background in some way. I decided to use my airbrush system for this because it's the easiest way to get a color gradient for the water. Therefore I had to cover the already colored parts of the mermaid with some transparent sticky foil and then airbrush my way. This way only the parts that are still white will get colored. For the stone, I layered the blue and the green again to make it look extra dark, then trying to layer down some stony texture too. After peeling the foil off of the picture, the drawing is nearly finished. Using the green again for some seaweed in the background and setting some highlights down with the white gel pen. This gives the picture even more dimensions. And then it's finished. I hope you liked the result. I really loved this challenge and maybe I will do another one if you liked it too.